What is up, Hustle Babes? So today is April 8th and it is currently 9:38 a.m. and I have a full day planned. Like, I probably won't even get home until like 10 p.m., right? So today I'm actually meeting with Tatiana O'Hara, and she is a operations coach. She really does get like your team and your processes together so that you can step into the CEO role that you are supposed to be doing in your business. Because honestly, when you start a business, you are usually a one-man team at first. And then as you grow, it can be hard to let go certain tasks, or just hard to build those processes so that you don't have to work so much in your business. You can just work on your business. You get what I'm saying? Hey, baby, girl, you got it. So baby, in a bag, in a bag. My assistant Jasmine is actually coming with me, but I want to show y'all something real quick. Don't laugh at my hair because I didn't flat iron my hair yet. Y'all, I was supposed to be ready at 8:45. It turned into 9:15 and it's currently 9:38. And we actually have to leave by like 10. So I'm gonna make this pretty quick because I am also recording on Instagram story. But I want to show y'all my outfit real quick. Let me see. This, I don't know if this is gonna show you it. So I am going to try to show you in the bathroom mirror. As you can see, I have on this like blazer dress thing. I actually wore this by itself before. It has like little frills at the bottom. And then I have on my Hustle Babe dress. Oh my God. Let me see. I don't know if y'all can see it. Let me go in this mirror. Maybe you can see it a little bit better, but like, this is the bottom of it. And then I have on a Hustle Babe dress that I got made yesterday. So that's what I have on. I'm gonna put on heels, of course. But that is the look. And when you see full body, it's real cute. And it comes with a little belt. I'm probably not keeping this belt in, but right now it's in because I haven't decided yet. But yeah. So we just made it. We just parked. Jasmine's back there. Say. Are you excited?
I'm so excited. We're about to put in work, okay?
Right? We're about to put in work. So I already told y'all who we're meeting today. So today is actually going to be a very long day for us. We're going to be here until 7, I think. It is currently 11 on the dot. So, but we're going to be here until 7. We are really going to be working on ripping our team and processes apart and putting them back together way better, right? So me and Jasmine are in for a lot of brain power work today. And so we had to get a long night's sleep tonight, but I'm gonna try to capture as much as I can for you guys without ruining the integrity of our brand and what we're working on, or Tatiana's brand. But I already told her that she's going to be meeting you guys today. So she's excited for that. And we're gonna do like a little, I don't know what I'm gonna get. So I'm not even gonna promise you guys anything, but I will get some footage for you guys throughout the day. So let's go.
Essentially, the reason why we want to go back over this again is just to make sure there's no holes, make sure we're super clear on everything that you're trying to work towards. And then everything that we do throughout the day is going to be heading back to the vision, essentially, like making sure that everything is in alignment with it. So we're just gonna kind of go through and answer some of those questions, like, you know, when do you see this happening for yourself? Kind of painting the picture of what you want your day-to-day to look like, what you want your team to look like, your personal life, all of that. So you can just kind of start dumping it out and I'll type it all in.
Okay, no problem. So kind of sticking with some of the things I said before, I really want, like, one, overall, I want the impact to be there for the people that we help. And by impact, I mean that we know that 9 times out of 10, we're changing people's lives, hopefully 10 times out of 10. And so that means that I want a great customer experience. So I want high customer ratings when it comes to feedback from whether it's our agency side services or whether it's working with me.
I really want to see that coming in. Within my team, I want everyone to kind of be their own little expert in their position. So that means like they're performing like beast mode pretty much with everything that they're doing. I want there to be obviously everybody can't be a leader, but I want to see the leaders within my team. So that way when it's time to expand and hire, I physically don't have to do every single aspect of the training, and it can be okay, maybe we have a senior graphic designer training one of the other graphic designers or something like that. With me and what I want to do, I see myself kind of being the face, so doing the content, photo shoots, video shoots, that stuff won't change, can't change. And I really do like brainstorming my content too for my... supply enough so that they can have benefits and all that stuff, and it really be like a lifestyle for them, like they can do whatever they want with that money and with those benefits. And if someone were to have kids and stuff like that, what else?
It's giving me that weird thing. Look at how beautiful this flow chart is that Tatiana designed for us. It's kind of scaring us because all of these people here, we don't know who's gonna pay up.
But so far we are like, what, 60 or 70% done with today, and we've gotten to the nitty gritty stuff, and it is exciting. But now we gotta hash out the team and what this power team or Charmin team is gonna look like.
Do you know why I say Charmin team?
The ish, no toilet paper, remember? Yeah, but yeah, let us get back to work and we'll see you afterwards. So we are done with the work part of today, and we are about to go eat some dinner and have some drinks and really just recap on all the work we just did, because we just did a lot of brain work, right? So much that I found myself getting a little brain tired, but I was like, brain, thank you. I was like, brain, we gotta step out of it and do this work. But it was just so good, y'all. I'm gonna tell y'all about like just the overall experience. You know what? I'm gonna tell y'all about the overall experience once I get home, and just how amazing Tatiana is, so that maybe you can hire her to help you with your operational side of your business as you grow and scale. So you see Jasmine, I don't know if I showed y'all her shirt today.
Yes!
Right? And then I showed y'all my dress, so. But yeah, now we're at Raising the City, we're about to go inside. And I got home. Me and Jasmine put a little bit of the things up, and Jasmine is now on her way home. And I kind of just wanted to sum up what happened today, right? Because I explained a little bit of it on my Instagram, but I don't know if I gave you guys full detail on what's going on. And I just want to talk about how today was for me. So I am in the process of rebuilding, rebranding, and relaunching, right? And it may come to a surprise to a lot of people that I actually rebranded twice and relaunched once, right? And so this is something that a lot of my coaching clients, so a lot of the people who book strategy sessions, they're on the fence about what relaunching would look like for them, because they either didn't launch correctly or they launched without the full strategy and the full branding foundations. And so they're always like, okay, what does relaunching look like for me? What does rebranding look like for me? And so I like to tell people that it isn't something that you should be scared of. I like to break it down into three different tiers, right? So this is like rebranding is a good thing, like in a way, right? Because it's like, it means that you are getting clarity. Like, so you're gaining clarity on something and you're trying to improve, right? Because you can be tier one where unfortunately you didn't launch correctly. And so you didn't really make any type of impact or generate any results, right? Or you could be tier two where you launched, you had some luck, but you realized with a lot of that was momentum because maybe you had a strong support system or something, and now you can't seem to get results to kind of regulate themselves, right? And to be always around. Or you could be tier three where you do consistently make sales, but you're at a point where you want to elevate your business, transform your brand, and build or even scale your team. And you can't do that until you fix certain things internally, rebrand yourself as this new and improved version of yourself, like your business 2.0, and really just elevate to a new level, right? So whether that involves you changing pricing, evolving your target audience, transforming from affordable to higher end, whatever that looks like, that is something that you would want to rebrand and potentially relaunch for. So right now, I'm in tier three, right? So I currently make a decent amount of money every single month. I am making much more than I ever made in anybody's corporate job, right? Now, with that being said, when I did AAR, right? So if you don't know what AAR is, it is Audit, Analyze, and Reinvent. And I can make a video on it if you want me to. But when I did my AAR, which is me reflecting on my numbers for the month and the quarter, I do AAR for internal affairs as well. And I realized that there were broken pieces within my team and my processes that needed to be fixed if I wanted to elevate to hit my $1 million year next year, right? Pretty much. So I decided to fix all these things. So I literally made a note of all these changes and I made potential solutions to these changes. And I realized that it was just so much to do. And I was doing a lot of like band-aid work when I was like, look, we just got to fix the broken bone and build from there. So I found an operations coach. So I started looking for an operations coach. I actually ended up seeing a familiar face that I had ran into before. And then I saw some other people, but then I was watching a YouTube video and this particular person used this person as well and raved about her services. So I said, okay, well, let me go look into her again. And so as I looked into her again, I realized that she was exactly what I needed, right? So this person is Tatiana O'Hara, and pretty much she is like a superwoman, right? And no, I wasn't paid to say this. No, this isn't a sponsorship or anything. Literally, I went in there so excited. And she did exactly what I thought she would do plus more. We literally ripped my team apart, right? We ripped our processes apart. We kind of outlined things that I should be doing as a CEO, what makes me happy within my business, cut certain offerings, restructured certain things, restructured our processes, solidified roles, added on new roles, built out my organizational chart. Like, we did so much today. Like, I was with her for literally 12 hours. Some of those hours we were eating, as you saw, but I was with her for so long and we got so much done. And tomorrow she's sending me all this stuff. So the good thing about it is I don't even have to remember this stuff on the top of my head. Yes, Jasmine was there. We took notes and things like that. But she took notes in her own workbook that she's giving me, which is like a step-to-step guide on what we covered today. So it comes with instructions, but it also comes with like the notes from today. I get all the stuff I just told you about, all of the visuals, all of that stuff like handed to me, which is just so bomb, because over the course of the next month or so, we are working on everything within the business. Okay, so we have slowed our business down tremendously, and I'm prepped for it, but we have slowed our business tremendously so that we can take the time to really improve our processes, to improve our customer experience, because that is something that really grinds my gears. And one of the pain points in business is as you grow, sometimes you're going to outgrow your processes. So what was working for me before when I was a team of one and a team of three doesn't work anymore now that I'm generating and bringing in more orders, right? And it's not necessarily that we can't handle it. It's just that the processes aren't keeping up with the expectations and we need to fix that gap. So it was amazing. I hope that you guys enjoyed the little bits and pieces that you did see. I am going to be doing a lot of content on just my rebrand and relaunch process to just be transparent with you guys because, like I said, a lot of you guys are in that phase and you don't know what it looks like and you think that it may be a bad thing. And if you think that, comment down below that. If you thought that rebranding or relaunching is always negative, comment below. But it doesn't always have to be a bad thing. It can be very exciting because you know you're about to unlock next level. I know once I'm done with this rebrand and relaunch, I'm hitting a million. Like it's no doubt about it. I'm hitting a million, right? And so I'm super excited about it. In the future, I do want to help people specifically who didn't launch the right way, who maybe launched and had some sales and they're missing branding foundation, and even people who want to level up and they need to kind of restructure a few things, do some AAR in their business and like go to the next level. That's what I want to help people with. So I'm excited, and I'm excited to show you how it looks on me before I help you do it. So yeah, but anyway, I'm about to go ahead and shower and take off this very, very cute dress, you know, and wrap up today. So I will see y'all in the next vlog. All right, peace.